Hello and welcome to my unboxing and first look at my first ever DOXA watch. It's the DOXA SUB 200. I wanted this watch for quite some time. It's in the orange. It was a hard choice to pick between the orange and the sort of turquoise and yellow. I already own a turquoise dial colored watch and kind of a yellow one and definitely an orange one, so it wasn't about picking up a color that was missing in the collection. Anyway, here it is in this box. Really excited about opening this. I've gone through a kind of diver watch phase at the moment with the Zodiac. I'm really impressed with this Zodiac watch. So much so, I would love to pick up another one at some point. But let's open this DOXA. Thought I'd color match a little bit with the orange, the Spyderco. I think it's in here. Got a big package, really. Lots of packing foam. So it says DOXA 1889. And there we go. So this is how DOXA package their watches. Completely different to the Zodiac. You can find the Zodiac unboxing on the channel as well. So it comes in this waterproof type case. Maybe it's waterproof, I'm not sure. I think it might be. Got a little ring there. And we've got this. There's this document, but there's no card there, so I don't know what that's about. But very nice. So it's an automatic watch, so it's just powered by your movement, you know, moving the wrist. I think this can be hand wound as well. Little history. So this DOXA 1889, the Zodiac 1882. And I don't think I'll ever own a Rolex Submariner or a Blanc Pon. So, you know, these two are kind of like the next best thing for me, really. So let's unzip this. I don't even feel like I'm unboxing a watch with this case. Oh, and there it is. It's sort of like... to what must have been moved about a little bit. So yeah, that looks fine. Oh, there's the card. So it's actually in this box. Get a lanyard. Not sure about that. And oh, you get one piece of foam and some silica gel, so we can take those out. They're not really needed, so we can get rid of those. But yeah, not sure about this lanyard thing. But there you go. It's got the DOXA fish on it, and yeah, there's your. Yeah, there's your warranty card. Not sure why it's got free spaces for cards. Maybe if you purchase other DOXAs, you could have them all in one holder, but yeah. Okay, let's have a look at this watch itself then. I've got a tag there, and the buckle is nicely protected. I went for the orange strap, you know, the rubber strap. Feels quite nice. Probably say it's softer than the Zodiac. It's not fragranced whatsoever. I was really surprised with Zodiac because it's vanilla fragranced, and it's my first watch that has been fragranced, and I didn't even think that that was a thing. I thought, you know, maybe someone who made it was wearing a bit of perfume or something, but yeah, it smells a bit of vanilla, and that has lasted, although I haven't got it too wet yet, so maybe it'll disappear over time. I'm not that fussed, but it's a nice smell. It smells a little bit like Tic Tacs. Yeah, there's the, and it has a sticker on the back. Get my fingerprints all over this. Screw down, case back, as you'd expect, just like the Zodiac. The lug width is 19 millimeters, and that's quite an odd lug width. I would have liked 20 millimeters as the Zodiac and the Seiko Monster have. Water resistant, 20 atmospheres, Swiss made, sub 200, sapphire crystal. Yeah, it's a lovely orange. The orange is what I expected. It matches the strap perfectly. It's very shiny. There's distortion around the edge. It's not a flat sapphire crystal. It's domed, so it raises up past the bezel and then domes across. Whereas the Zodiac is slightly domed, slightly raised above the bezel, but this is definitely raised above the bezel. So that means that there is a bit of distortion from the sides. Yeah, as I say, I went for the strap because I like the colour, and to get these rubber straps separately. I think what's great about DOXA is you can buy all their accessories and things off their website here in the UK, whereas Zodiac you can't, which I think they're missing a huge market there. If you're selling your watches around the world, you know, it would be good if your store was international as well. And then that also raises the question of servicing and warranty and things. But yeah, I can't get different coloured straps or metal bracelets with this, like at all. Whereas this DOXA, I can. The only downside is the rubber strap is almost as much as the metal bracelet, which is just ridiculous anyway. And I may get a metal strap for it. I've heard that the metal bracelet is very comfortable. Yeah, I'm quite impressed with this. It's actually surpassed my expectations having it in hand. The bezel is quite close to the case. It's polished as well, like the Zodiac, which is fine. But what I mean by that is there's not much of a gap between the case and the actual bezel, which means your fingers, you're kind of pinching like the top of it. Whereas the Zodiac, you have a bit more room, it sticks out taller, and also the bottom part of the case overspills. It's further out than the bezel, whereas again the Zodiac, the bezel itself is overhangs the whole case, and so that's a bit trickier to grip, not only with the polished but the size of the bezel compared to the overlapping case. I don't know whether many people have sort of noticed that. Face is lovely. I'm not so fussed about the date window. I think it could have just not had a date window and it would have looked cleaner. I do like the clean text though. You know, it just literally says DOXA sub 200 and then Swiss made. Don't think it needs to say anything else. Some of their watches with the different colours say like pearl white and things. I'm not you know, keen on that. I think just have the colour and just classify it as that. Compared to like the Zodiac, which has a Zodiac logo, which obviously the DOXA doesn't have on there. It says Zodiac, then it says what watch it is. It's a Super Seawolf. Then it says automatic. Then it says 200 meters / 660 feet. Then it says Swiss made. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 5. So you've got 5 sets of literature and company logo. Whereas the DOXA, you've just got those two. I'm a bit concerned about the Loom pip, if that is actually, you know, usable and things. We'll find out. But yeah, the bezel action, it's very firm, but no back play. It's just, it's hard to grip onto. And yeah, it is hard to grip onto. So it's not too bad there, but then the crown gets in the way a little bit. But there's just not much of the bezel to grip. You kind of have to grip onto the case to then grip to the bezel. But the bezel action's nice. No back play. The Zodiac, there's like a little bit back play for each one, but it's still solid. Well, this one is anyway. So, crown action. Let's wind this one up. I've not been changing the time and the date as per the Zodiac instructions. I don't want to do anything on the, you know, to the watch that could affect it. So I've been avoiding changing the time and date as per the instructions, and I think I'll just follow the same for this DOXA. If I want to change the time and date, it'll be you know, before 10 o'clock at night or after 2 o'clock in the morning. So typically before 10 o'clock at night, if I even need to do that. So you pull it out once, and then we've got the date, and it is the 18th today. So we'll go for that. Not a hard click when you're turning the crown. And then we should be able to set the time, which is actually, now I wonder if this will change the date. No, good. So that is, that will do for now. And then I'm gonna wind it up. Okay, and as well documented, it's impossible to overwind automatic watches. I mean, of course it is. Why wouldn't it be? Because it's using the movement of your wrist. You know, if it was wound fully and then you moved your wrist again, if that wasn't the case, you could move your wrist and overwind the watch. So what you're gonna do, not move your wrist at all. I must say that it's the knurling on the crown is again polished and a bit tricky to hold onto when you're changing, when you're unscrewing it. Not like the Zodiac, which is very pronounced. Is the crown bigger? I'm not sure. I think it is. But size-wise, I think they're very similar sized, 40 mil. It just seems like the DOXA is bigger because it doesn't have that white chapter ring, is it? On the dial. I do like how the minute hand goes all the way to the edge, but that's affected by how domed it is because there's distortion. Whereas the Zodiac, no distortion around there. The date window looks exactly the same. And the indices are obviously longer on the DOXA, and the minute hand goes all the way to the minute. I don't mind the squared off hands and the indices on the Zodiac. I think it's fine. I do like the minutes on the bezel as well, which you're not getting on the dock, so you kind of have to guess. Yeah, I know they're quite far out there, but I tend to use them a fair bit. You're gonna have to judge the minutes on the dial rather than the bezel for the DOXA. I would have liked some orange minute rings. But yeah, they both have their qualities. But maybe I'm a bit biased because I've had the Zodiac for like a month and really gotten used to it. But how does it wear on wrist? The one thing I will enjoy is the strap. Like, the strap is soft and comfortable, but size-wise, for me, I think my wrist is just a little bit too, not small, it's like 7-inch wrist, but for one of the sizes, I'm kind of in between sizes, and I would have liked those to be definitely maybe half the size. I know they've gone for aesthetics over sort of comfortability, but as I say, this is a very soft watch, but I would have liked those holes to be just closer together, really, and more of them. But the Tropic strap is lovely. The buckle, it is odd that it's not bent, but it's that's the design of it, because that makes it putting on and off a little bit different. This has turned into like a Zodiac Doxa comparison, hasn't it? So they're the undersides of the watch. I like how the Zodiac's, you know, the strap, you can go all the way back. And it's a 20mm, probably more popular sized lug width, as opposed to the Doxa that is kind of, yeah, firm. And the strap itself goes all the way to the case. It's more like an integrated rubber strap. The texture is on the back as well. I'm not sure I like that. It might have been nicer if it was just smooth. You know, they can do it, look, that's smooth there. The buckle is very big though. You look at the size of that buckle. Well, it's huge. It's over two times the size of the Zodiac. But yeah, let's see how this feels on wrist. Yeah, that fits lovely on that size as well. Only one strap keeper, but yeah, that's lovely. That sits well on the wrist as well. I've got a 7-inch wrist, or just a bit larger than 7 inches. Very nice. Great first impressions. I think the buckle could have been a little bit smaller. I'm not sure why it needs to be that big, and also squared off. It's a bit sharp. And the strap itself, that could have been a 20mm. I think the 19 looks, dare I say, a little bit too small. And a 20mm orange strap would have had more of an impression. But I'm getting really, really picky now after wearing the Zodiac for a month. Weight wise, there's not much in it. I mean, the Zodiac's probably a little bit heavier, but I'd have to put them both on the scales. But yeah, there you go. That's my unboxing and first look at my favourite orange watch, along with the little comparison with the Zodiac. What do you guys think of the Sub 200 and Doxa? Do you own a Doxa? Please do put your thoughts and opinions down in the comments below. It'd be good to hear from you. Thank you for watching. The Emperor Protects.